Hi, this is another aircraft instrument. So this time it's an altimeter. This altimeter is from Smith. This thing is vintage. I think it was manufactured in 62. The range is 0 to 100,000 feet. So on the front, you have the indication in the mechanical digital display here. And you have also the Colesman window here, which permits to correct the air pressure. So the indication is in millibars. And we have on this side the connector for power supply and output signals. And we have the input static pressure port here. So let's open this thing. There are only 4 screws on the rear of this instrument. And there is a seal here. Okay, so it was a bit difficult. So let's see if we can open this thing. It's not obvious. Okay, so this is a spacer, which should provide the link between this knob here and something which should be here. Okay, this square rod here. Okay. So I make a zoom on this thing. So we have two capsules on the back of this thing, but it will be difficult to remove as we have electrical connections. Okay, so let's see how this thing works. Okay, so we have obviously a zero detector here. So this is a kind of LVDT sensor. So this is common in this type of instrument. So you have a coil here, which is a primary coil. And you have two secondary coils here, which are in series, in phase opposition. So you have a E shape here, and the I shape, which is separated. Here, I don't know if we can see on the camera. But you see that moving this I shape will modify the amplitude on both on secondaries here, and depending on the angle position of the I bar relative to the E shape here, you will have a differential voltage which will be in phase or out of phase relative to the primary voltage here. And this I shape here should be linked to the capsule. I think we can see maybe on that side. It's difficult to see, but so the I shape is attached to this cam here, and also to the capsule through this little mechanic piece here. So when the capsule moves, this will produce a change in the relative position of this I shape here, and this will provide an unbalanced signal at the output of this sensor. Normally this signal should be amplified and fed to the servo motor, and the servo motor should change the position of this thing through this cam here. So let's see what's happened in the motor side. So the servo motor is here. So this is an AC motor. It should have 5 terminals here. Okay, so the motor will change the position of the needle and the digital indication here. And also the motor will also activate. We have two screws. This one is for the, yes, is to modify manually the air pressure. Okay, but we have this. Okay, so this is this one. Okay, so you have here this pinion here is linked to this one here, and this one will rotate this rod here, and you have a differential gear here. Yeah, so this differential gear will rotate this pinion, which is made with copper, it seems. And this pinion is attached to this cam here, this cam. And this will change the position of this thing in order to retrieve the zero, the new position. And you can see that the two secondaries are in series. You have this green wire here, which connects the two secondaries in opposition. So it seems there is the amplifier, maybe is on this board here. We have a few transistors, but I'm not sure. No, it is not enough to. So I think we need an external amplifier for this. I'm not sure. Probably. And these are not transistors, they are only two wires. It seems. Yeah, so the amplifier should be external. So it will be difficult to make working this thing. We need an external amplifier. And we have adjustment of the static pressure. So this is made using this rod here. Normally this should change the position of the LVDT sensor, but I cannot see the link. So when the knob is rotated, so this provides a change on this lever here. So this lever pushes. Ah, okay, I see now. Okay, so there is a link here. Ah, okay, the entire pinion. Okay, so there is a lever here. This lever here is also attached to this rod here. Okay, and as the rod can move, this permits to rotate this pinion and to modify the cam. The cam moves the same way than the cam moves with the motor. You can change the position of this cam using either the motor or the rotation of the pressure setting here. So we can test maybe this differential LVDT. We just have to power this the middle coil here and sense the voltage with the oscilloscope between the external terminals here. This is easy to do. I will prepare the setting for this test. I will use a 26 volt AC. I will make a zoom out and show the oscilloscope the same time. So maybe I can try to find the corresponding terminals on the connector. Okay, we have this one. Okay. Okay, so the power supply of the sensor activates also the flag. And probably also the primary of the servo motor, but I'm not sure. Anyway, this thing it makes a lot of noise. I will also search for the connections of the sensor. Okay, so we have one here. And the second one is here. Okay. I will reduce the amplitude to maybe less noisy. Okay, I need to trigger with an external reference signal. I will use the output trigger of the function generator for that purpose. Okay, so we try to move the high bar. Okay, so you can see that there is a very specific position where the signal is zero, otherwise it is in phase or out of phase. Okay, and this is very sensitive. Okay, so we can see on the hidden plate of the motor here, at least the specification says we need a reference phase of 115 volts and the control phase is 20 volts. So we need at least 115 volts for the reference phase of the motor. And we need an amplifier which can deliver 20 volt RMS. And I don't know the purpose of this small electronic board here. But it seems that all connections are external. Anyway, this instrument cannot be tested in standalone mode. So I think it should be interesting to find an amplifier and try to make working this altimeter. You can see also if I adjust the Colesman window in order to have 1013 millibars, we are close to zero altitude, because we need to move a little bit the altitude to have the zero. So here you have zero for an altitude of minus 200 feet. Otherwise, it's possible to adjust the pressure in order to have zero also. You can see the equivalent air pressure to have zero altitude. Okay, so this is somewhere here, close to that position. So 1020 millibars. So I think this thing should work if I can find an amplifier in order to amplify the error signal and to feed this signal to the AC motor. So I'll try to find something. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.